Hi class, this is Professor Lowry here to teach you guys about accounting. Today in class, we're going to be learning about FIFO versus LIFO. Class, did anyone do the homework last night and can tell me what FIFO stands for and what LIFO stands for?
Oh, I know.
Tom.
It's FIFO is first in, first out.
Good. And what about LIFO?
Me? Last in, first out.
Correct. So today, class, I prepared a chart explaining FIFO versus LIFO. Here we have three different purchases from three different points in the month, all at 10 units and different prices in an area of inflation, $5, $10, $15, which would mean that they cost different prices. Also, we have an operating expense to purchase our t-shirts. Tom, didn't you get 100 on the homework?
Why, yes, I did.
Would you like to explain to the class?
I would love
FIFO?
To.
Thank you.
Well, with FIFO, because it's first in, first out, here are your dates here. You're going to take the first 22 units. So we're going to take 10 from here, leaving 0, 10 from here, leaving 0, and only 2 from here. So that leaves 8. So then if you look over here, we have this sums up to 22 units. So you have 10 from the first, from January 1st, you have 10 from January 15th, and you have 2 from January 28th. And you have our prices here. When you multiply these out, you have 10 times 5 equals 50, and then et cetera for 130, and which totals 180. So this $180 is your COGS, is your cost of goods sold.
And Tom, can you tell the class what we do with the products that we don't sell?
Absolutely. So you have an ending inventory. So because we only use 22 units, we have 8 units left over on January 28th. So that's our ending inventory here. We have 8 units left over. On January 28th, the price was $15. So that's the price of $15 there. When you multiply these, it leaves you with $120. And that is your inventory cost right there.
Great explanation, Tom. And so in this problem, we sold 22 units at $20, which gave us a revenue of $440. And as Tom said, our cost of goods sold was $180. So to go to the next step in the problem, we need to calculate our gross margin, which is our revenue minus our cost of goods sold, which gives us $260. What we also have to factor in is the expense from the problem. Right here we have an operating expense of $40, which we need to subtract from our gross margin to get $220, which is our net income. Since Tom did such a good job presenting FIFO, Lydia, would you like to do LIFO?
Yes, please. So for LIFO, you take from the last order. And because it's 22, you also take from the second order and only 2 more from the first order. So altogether, after multiplying from the prices, you actually get 160, which is your COGS, cost of goods sold. Then for your ending inventory, you will only have 8 units left over, but at the price of 5. So instead, you'll have $40 of cost in the ending inventory.
Thank you, Lydia. And as I explained with FIFO to Tom, we have the same problem where we sold $440 worth of our t-shirts. But in this problem, since it was LIFO, our cost of goods sold was different, leaving us with a different gross margin. But in LIFO versus FIFO, we have to keep the expenses the same, which gives us a net income of $240, because we subtract from $280, $40, $240, net income. Any last questions, class?
Professor Lowry.
Lydia.
What's matching?
Have I taught you nothing?